Ah, gosh, always terrifies me when that happens. Hello again. Welcome to Code Therapy, which is therapy for me, not for you. Every time I manage to find some time in my copious free time, I like to code. And I like to code because it keeps me sane. There we go. We've done a few of these. We've done, two. And we've been working on the same project. And when I say we, I'm of course using the royal we here. It's just me sitting on my own with the July the 4th fireworks blasting out behind me. And we've been working on the same thing, which is this dual and back program. I've now explained dual and back more times than I feel comfortable with, but I'll do it one more time. Dual and back is a sort of mind game for people wanting to improve their memory. And it's pretty simple. It shows you a little grid like this and little blocks appear on it. And what you have to do is you have to kind of remember what the last block but one was, like where it was in the grid. And when and if a block appears in that position, two steps on, you go, oh my goodness, it's a position match. And the N in the title is the number of steps back that you need to remember back. So that's what we're trying to achieve here. And to do that, we're using this, Elm, which is a pretty awesome language that compiles down to JavaScript and runs in the browser and is loosely inspired by Haskell and other functional immutable programming languages, which is something that always bends my brain. So I'm sort of playing around with this to try and see if I can get some of the stuff that was really excited me about Haskell and apply it into the world of the web. A few housekeeping things. If you want to chat, you can go to the Twitch chat channel at twitch.tv/codetherapy, or you can go on IRC. The link should be pretty close to where you're seeing this, but if you haven't seen it already, let me give it in the prompt at the bottom here. Come to irc.oftc.net, code therapy channel, or web chat, oftc.net, or twitch.tv/codetherapy. Yeah. There we go. And you can join me and ask questions anytime you want. There we go. There's me talking in it. And I'll happily try and answer those questions. The chat should appear at the bottom. I just hacked this thing together. I'm just starting to understand how Twitch holds itself together. So if you look down there, I am going to respond to chats that appear down there. Okay, well, let's get started. I have last, when you last saw us, I was in the dual mbac directory, and I had just sort of started from scratch again. We did a sort of guided tour in episode 2 of some experiments that I had in, switch these two around. There we go. In programming dual mbac. But I junked all of that and at the end of the last episode and sort of started again, partly because to give an idea of where we were so you didn't miss anything, and partly because the little foray that I'd done didn't seem to be the best way of coding this particular program. So I am now going to take and have a look at it. And the place that we left it, we'd actually got this thing running, just going to... You hear the fireworks behind me? It's very exciting. My cat is going mental. Just going to start the web browser that will automatically compile these things. Webpack go! Split this terminal so all of that can go on up there, but we don't have to pay attention to it unless we need to. And so have a look at this. So one of the things, I've said this before, but one of the things I like about Elm is that you get this sort of instant feedback of what you're doing. And programs generally run okay if you get them to compile, which is sometimes a challenge, but at least you don't end up with bugs in your working code. You just end up with annoying messages in your programming life. Let's see now. Okay, so we got to the point where we formed this little grid here. We were concentrating on the idea of like, well, how do we do that big 9-element grid, and how can we programmatically display a big blob in one of those pages? And the way we did that is we have deck here, we have a card which has a particular position, and we have something that displays one of those cards. We have this thing which will display the deck, actually the top of the deck here. And this generates some HTML. If you squint, you can see what the HTML is. We have a table here, a table element. We have some table rows. And then we have some things that generate here a TD, which is a table data, I guess that stands for in HTML. This is all creating some really basic HTML here, which might show here. No, I always do this. Scroll down. We go. Table. Some table rows. It's like those table rows are these table Ds. Okay. And all of that is generated by JavaScript that is compiled from Elm. Okay, so I think the next thing to do is to try and make this actually look like a grid and a blob. And I think we're going to do that by creating some style sheets. What we're going to do is create some styles. But we're not going to use style sheets. We're going to programmatically generate it, which is kind of weird. But I think that will let me kind of explore that particular element of Elm, and it's also something that we can fiddle around with here rather than spending some time fiddling around with CSS. So the first thing that we have is we kind of need to make these boxes a bit bigger, and I think that I don't know, people are probably going to laugh at my clumsy literal stylings of this spreadsheet, but I am gonna... Oh, great. Oh, everything suddenly paused for a moment there. Did it pause on your end? Maybe it was a particularly hard thing to render. Okay, so this is the way we do it. Well, let's just make sure. I'm just gonna make sure I get the style right here. Nope. Can find out what it's looking for. Looking for white space at deck view model. Oh, did I fail to close this in some way? Yeah. Oh, there's this weird thing with Vim that you have to set up. I put Vim because I'm saying it at the same time as I'm typing it. Copy. Cause yes. If I do that, it will spot it automatically. Star is expecting one argument was given two. Oh, right, so we've just put the brackets in the wrong place here. Great. Okay, that looks pretty good. So instead of background color, let's make this width. Instead of red, let's make it good. Now, I'm not sure you can do, I'm not sure that height is even a sensible thing to do in CSS. I remember that from my ancient past, but let's have a look. CSS TD style. Right. Huh. Okay, so there's an old-fashioned attribute you can set. Use CSS. Right. Okay, so we can do this. Well, that's exciting. Usually, I find it with CSS that everything you think is going to be easy ends up being ridiculously hard, and vice versa. You know, it's not all bad. Oh goodness, what happened? Oh, I should have made this too. A list of tuples. No? Oh. Humiliating typos. Ah! Right, here we go. Uh-huh. Interesting. I don't see. Oh, no! No, look, there we go. This is really big. It's actually much bigger than I anticipated. So maybe we'll take these both down to 100 for now. All right, good. So that looks much more like the dual in back grid. I mean, not very like the dual in back grid. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. But we do have a group of 9 here. And now, well, we could either do 2 things, both of which are a bit tricky, but not terribly tricky. The first one is to get these borderlines correct, these this grid, and that is going to be somewhat dependent on the position. So this one in the middle should have all 4 outlines there, and these ones on the edges should not. I think maybe should we do? I could go either way. I sort of envisage both of these things being a little bit more complicated than I really care for. But I think the blob is going to be pretty. Here's what we can do. We can do a sort of default blob and then come back to it. And then that means that we will feel we've done something. Well, I've done something and you've vicariously got a thrill from watching me. Let's see. So in our current setting, we say text X else text 0, and then we stick it in here. Well, in fact, what we could do is just not have anything there. make this return border, oh sorry, background color red. My typing is a little skew-iff today. I think it's because of the way I'm sitting. Sorry, that's incredibly distracting, isn't it? A bit annoying. So I'll close it away. Put this over to here. Else, do you say none or white? Oh, let's say white for now. Now it's gonna go, oh my god, I wasn't expecting that. Let's see what this error is. Sort of interesting. Why is it? Oh, because look, it's saying, see, once again, the error messages are now so awesome. This branch is returning something completely different from this branch. And so we really need it to be consistent. And we can. Okay, background color. Feeling there's an improvement I can make in this area, but I'm not going to do it right now. If you're enjoying this, feel free to jump into the chat and like heckle me. I presume it's working. Sorry, the last few days have been